My name is Philip Chung. Currently, I'm actually a staff researcher here at UCSF, but starting in the fall, I'll be a medical student. My area of research is focused toward developing medical devices that are wireless, low cost, low power to try and improve patient quality of care and the quality of life, and also to provide these tools to doctors so that they can achieve the same goal. I'm originally from the Los Angeles area, from a suburb called Arcadia. And, you know, I grew up in a household where there were a lot of kind of technical-minded people. So my mother is a software engineer, my dad is an electrical engineer. So being in that environment, there was always, you know, random electronics strewn around on our dining and coffee table. And, you know, I just became curious, and so that definitely helped shape me and made me want to pursue a path toward engineering and science. There was a lot of disability and handicap in my family. So my father, during the Chinese Cultural Revolution, before he immigrated to the United States, he suffered a pretty bad knee injury, so he has chronic knee pain, and that has definitely kind of impacted me on a daily basis. You know, as a young kid, I couldn't fully understand or appreciate why he was always kind of limping around the place. You know, when we go on vacations, me and my brother would kind of run ahead, and then, you know, we look back and like, hey, you know, why is our dad not able to kind of keep pace with us? At one point in my childhood, I distinctly remember, and my parents always remind me, and saying that, you know, when I grow up, I'm gonna fix my dad's leg. While it's kind of silly to think about it now, because it's really, you know, it's really difficult in reality to do something like that, it's definitely kind of impacted me and kind of motivated me to continue down this pathway. Just think about what I had envisioned as a child and to see if something like that could actually happen in real life. That's one of the things that drives me forward. When I was an undergraduate in college, I pursued research as something that I would do kind of as a volunteer basis. And so that's where kind of I started learning my lab techniques and kind of got really interested in kind of answering these sort of research questions, answering hypotheses. I ended up taking a class at my undergraduate college. And in this class, we were supposed to build devices that kind of use some elements from cell experiments that I've done in the past, and then to build a device and then to do something novel with that device that could help enable better detection of diseases like malaria and so forth. So that sort of experience and kind of being able to build something with my hands was very gratifying, and that kind of led me toward the direction of doing medical devices rather than doing basic science, biology, or biochemistry type research, which I originally kind of was headed down that path. I think my greatest achievement so far is the project that I'm currently working on here at Dr. Shuval Roy's lab at UCSF. It was actually my master's thesis project. So, you know, after joining Dr. Roy's lab and working on this project, we were able to kind of build a few prototypes and then eventually test that device on a human subject. And now, you know, we've gone far beyond that. We're actually kind of scaling up to a bigger and bigger clinical study now with this type of device. The project is to find a better way to detect preterm birth. You know, pregnancy is about 37 weeks, give or take, but preterm birth is when a baby is born too soon. And right now, doctors, they don't really have the best way of detecting it. So the device we're building now does something similar in monitoring the cervix, like transvaginal ultrasound, but it fundamentally does it in a different way. So we're using electrical and optical sensors to look at the microscopic properties of the tissue itself. I think the future of a lot of medical science really is about interdisciplinary collaboration.
Yeah, I guess that's really cool.
There is small color difference.
Yeah.
This one's white or this one's
and
premium.
What I mean by that is you go to a research environment, typically you have scientists, grad students, postdocs, you go to a medical environment, typically you have, you know, medical students, residents, attending physicians, nurses. And the way that each career is taught to think is slightly different. And I think it's really about bringing those different backgrounds and trainings together, the different ways of thinking together, and to really share them. Because only by kind of understanding what the needs of the other end are and how the other half functions, can we really establish a good way to translate laboratory science into the clinic, and then from the clinic, motivate new things to kind of start looking at in the laboratory.